But if you're hearing things down inside that you could not know down in your spirit, that's the Holy Spirit telling you something.
Because until you begin to walk worthy, you aren't even considered for the position.
Gosh, what freedom it is to just say, hey, I can be kind and I can love you with no regret. Once you've made that decision to make Jesus your Lord, we no longer have to live like we're a sinner. But stop looking. Stop comparing who you are. Stop. Just focus on me.
But mighty people do things when it's uncomfortable.
He was promoted to cleaning up the tables. Why? Because the path to greatness always goes through the servants' quarters.
If the enemy can keep you busy, he's probably already won.
And you stand up in faith and rise, and he stands up right behind you.
And we can't hold on to life here and hold on to God. We can't, because one will lose grip.
And everything in our flesh is like, is this the Lord? Of course it's the Lord.
When we leave this place, he wants to go with us.
Let me tell you, the way you talk about your situation will either acknowledge God or it will deny him. Seriously, when he is with you, it changes everything.
See, something happens when we just decide, I'm just going to take him at his word, despite what seems to have not happened in the past. But as we begin to use his word, then more will be given to us.
He's trying to develop something in us so that we don't even just see what he does, but we actually are a people that knows his ways.
You have to get to a point in your life where you come to the Lord and you say, God, I want all that you have for me.
Give thanks, shout with joy, bow, kneel before me.
And all he's looking for is people willing to say, I align myself to your plan. I submit myself to you.
And I really hate that, because you shouldn't get out there and find out who you're supposed to be. You're supposed to get in here and live out who you already are.
And he's the one who's dealing with you. You're not an orphan. You haven't been left without God.
The presence of God is not just some goosebumps and some tingling in your fingers.
How will I not come through? How shall he not? How shall he not? How shall he not? How shall I not pay your bill?
Everybody in the body of Christ is called to do the work of the ministry.
Look at that mountain and walk around it. Know where to look at the mountain and what? Say, be removed and be cast into the sea.
And so our job on earth is to change the flavor of the world from a wicked flavor to a righteous flavor.
C.S. Lewis said, God is incredibly hard to satisfy. Incredibly easy to please.
Just one more commercial. I need you to spend more time in my word. Lord, I don't have time for that. Don't you know I already get up at 6 a.m? You might have to say no to some other stuff, right?
He doesn't give signs, he speaks.
And so what we need to allow ourselves is to be plugged into the source so that we can shine.
We saw the miracles, we heard the teachings, but we have something confirmed. The prophetic word of God.
Because when you know who I am, these situations don't matter to you. But he says, call out to me and I will answer. And I will show you great, great, great and inaccessible things that you do not know. Because as we come to him in our time of need, we will then be strengthened. Because I have the way that you need. I have the way out. But it comes with spending time with him.